that the Katha is taken from Ayodhya Khan and begins with this doha. Samachar tehi samaya suni siya uthi akulai jai sasu pad kamal jug bandi vaitahi surunaya siya pati ram chandra ki jai pavan sut hanuman ki jai moshu shankar bhagwan ki jai. Jai Ram Sri Ram Jai Jai Rama Sri Ram Jai Ram Jai 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 Ram Sri Ram Jai Jai Rama Sri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Rama. Came into being, yes, how she came to be born in the, or to appear, we should say, in the land of Mithila, where the king Janak was the king, was ruling. And so, there are many, many other aspects of this katha, why she came. One of the most popular ones is the shrap that was placed by Narad Muni on Vishnu Bhagwan when he sought the help of Lakshmi and ask her to take the form of Mohini, not to help him. You know, remember Naraji? He was getting too, as they say, too big for his boots. He thought he was the nearest and the dearest one of the Lord, and no one was a greater devotee than Bhagwan. And the Lord wants to show him that you cannot, you know, they say this abhiman, when it builds up in us, now it brings downfall. Yeah, because we think we're better than everybody else. It is not the case like this. And so the Lord always protects his devotee. But when he gave him the face of a banner and sent him to the swamber, of course, Muni did not place the banner around him. And he became very upset when he realized what had happened. And he placed a shrub on Vishnu Bhagwan. He says that you will come on this earth. Now when you come on this earth, this Lakshmi of yours will be taken away from you. And when this Lakshmi is taken away from you, no one will be there to help you except only monkeys. And so it is that all of this came to pass in Treta Yuga. And the Lord Vishnu did come as Rama. And Sita Maha just did. Lakshmi came as Sita. And so the Katha begins here that Dashrathji had already made all the plans for the coronation of Rama. When we all remember that Kekayi intervened on the instances of Mantara and asked the king, please give me those two vardans. And what did he ask for? That Rama must give up the throne. And as a second request, that he must go in the forest and stay there for 14 years, but live there as a hermit. So when all this happened, as you will understand, throughout the whole palace, this news is spreading like wildfire throughout the whole palace. As samacharati hi samaya suni siya kuti akulai, the katha begins here, that when Sita, when the news finally came to Sita, when she heard this, what did she do? What did she do? Jai sasu para kamala jugan. Yes, she went to her mother-in-law, to Kausalya, and she went and she fell at her feet. Fell at her feet. Dina yasi sasasu mridumani, ati sukumari dekhi akulani, vaiti hi namitas mukha sochati sita, rupa rasi pati prema punita. That, today, in today's world and today's language, we have to be very careful. Everyone has an idea and everyone has some knowledge and some comment to make on everything that we say. Now, but here, this is a perfect example of the perfect Bahu, the perfect daughter-in-law she was. And when she heard this news, she went to her mother-in-law to seek her blessings first, right? Because she already made up her mind. She did not disclose this to anyone. But she already made up her mind that if my Rama has to go, then I am not staying. I am not staying. So she, when she went and fell at her feet, she gave her blessings. And she spoke to Kausalya. Talana chahata bala jeevana natu, kehi sukriti sana hoi satu, ketanu prana ki kevara prana, vidi karatu kachu jai na jana. She's asking Madam Kausalya this question. Yes, she says, if my Lord, the one who is my life itself, is going to the forest, how can I stay behind? Oh, Mother, you tell me. My body, my spirit, yes, everything is bound together. When this vivah sanskar is done, these are the mantras that are chanted at that time in the wedding ceremony to bind you together. He says, he's telling Mother, what else can I do? I have no other choice. We will not read all the other passages, but then Kausalya Maha then starts to tell her, yes, that your father, Pita Janaka Bhupalamani, Sura Subhani Kulbani, your father is Janak. He is a jewel among all the kings. If you take this course of action, what will he think? Always we have to think about other people, before we do what we have to do. Yes? And so she's thinking, how will he feel? You were brought up in a palace. You never had to face any kind of hardship. And now if you go into this forest, what will happen there? How will you survive over there in this forest? That the life will be very difficult. Yes? And so Kausalya is in her heart of hearts, she's trying to tell her that no, you cannot go. You better stay where you are. But her mind was made up. And she says, wherever my husband will be, that is where I have to be. And so the Katha, the last bit of it that I want to read today, because we don't have much time, yes, is where the Lord and Sita Mata is having this discourse.